Hey guys, it's Myles. Welcome to episode 7 of Nightclub Photography TV. I'm your host, Myles, and in today's episode, we're going to be covering aperture settings. And just like every other episode, if this is the first time you're tuning into Nightclub Photography TV, all of these episodes are unscripted. Just think of a topic and we start discussing it just like we are friends at a bar, at a club, talking about photography. You ask a question, I answer your question straightforward and without the technical jargon. So in the last few episodes, we've been talking about different settings and what helps contribute to making good nightlife and nightclub photography photo. And wanted to move forward. We talked about flash exposure compensation, the basics of that, the basics of ISO. Now we're gonna move on and talk about aperture settings. And then in the next episode, we'll move on to shutter speed. Now, taking aperture as itself, okay, just alone, not even considering flash exposure compensation and ISO and shutter, it's, there's a lot of debate. Some people will want to shoot at an f-stop of 2.8 all the time. Some will want 3.5, 4. And others go a little bit higher. The highest I've seen a lot of photographers are the most common high f-stop I've seen is a 6.3, but I hardly ever see anyone use a 7.1 or 8 for nightlife photography inside of a club. But I would say the average for many nightlife photographers is between f4 and f5.6. You know, some people will say they use 3.5, some people will say they use 6.3, but personally, and with a lot of nightlife photographers I shoot with, it's around that f4, f5.6. Now, whatever I share with you guys today, it's all relative because the f-stop also is associated with your distance from your subject. So when someone says you can't shoot at f2.8 because if you focus on a specific point, the subjects or anyone outside of that point far on the edges of the frame, for instance, are going to be blurred up. Now, that's true if you are relatively close to your subjects. So let's say if I was shooting and my subjects were maybe 2 feet away from me, then yes, most likely the people across on the edges, or maybe if I was shooting a group of people and I had f2.8 and I was 2 feet away from them, yes, the people at the ends are going to be blurred up. Now, if I was really far away at f2.8, if I was, let's say, 10, 15, 20 feet away shooting at 2.8, there will be no effect. The people on the edges are not going to be blurred out. So distance is very important. You got to take that into consideration. So if I was shooting f5.6, for instance, if that would be more of a problem in terms of people being blurred at the edges, if that were the case, if I was closer to them rather than far away. So just keep that in mind. So what I talk to you guys about right now is going to be based on standing about 2 to 3 feet away from your subjects, because that's normally where I'm at. I'm about 2 to 3 feet away from them when I shoot them. And many times I'll be using kind of like a wide angle lens, a wide angle zoom lens. Sometimes I'll be even closer. Sometimes I'll be 1 to 2 feet away from them if it's a really crowded club. So take that into consideration. Aperture depends on distance also. So if you use f2.8, that doesn't necessarily mean the people on the ends of your frame, at the ends of your frame, are going to be blurred up. In any case, I want to cover that sweet spot. Most nightlife photographers shoot between f4 and f5.6. And I will show you kind of guys some of examples here. Now, I'm going to do my best to explain the scenarios I use these aperture settings at. And again, base it on that 2 to 3 feet distance from my subjects. Here are some photos that I took at f4.0. The first photo you are going to see, which is on the screen right now, is a good photo at f4.0. I like to shoot f4.0 at f4 if I am shooting only a few subjects, less than three, normally couples, or just two people paired up, and I'm relatively close, and I'm not trying to get anything in the background clear. And at this distance, I can make sure my subjects are very clear at f4. Now, the problem with f4 is sometimes, if I take a big group, they get lost in what do I mean is some of the subjects will be unclear. Take a look at this next photo where I was shooting at f4 and I was focused on one of the girls on the right. I forgot which one it was, and then all of a sudden she called her friends and all of her friends started coming across and joined the group and formed a line. I was shooting at f4 and I didn't even bother to refocus. I was locked on to one of the girls on the right and I just reframed my camera, the frame, so that I got everyone in there and just zoomed out. And it was already pre-focused. So what happened is at f4, you'll see that all four girls on the right are clear, but then the one on the left starts to get blurred out because I was shooting a big group at f4 from a distance of 2 to 3 feet. So that's a problem there. We don't want to shoot at that distance or that big of a group at f4. So this is where I'll move up to my next aperture f-stop, which is f5. I hardly shoot at f4.5. I shoot at f5, f5.6, or f4. Now at f5, you'll see I can shoot bigger groups. As you can see here, I get a bigger, here's another photo, I get a bigger group, and at f5, it's relatively clear. I can get a bigger group into my frame and focus at the center, and everyone else will be clear, as you can see in this picture. Here's another photo at f5, and the problem here, though, is that all of my subjects are not in a line. Now there are some people who are closer to the camera than others. Some are a little further back. So the people who are at the same distance from the camera, they're clear, but those further back are unclear. As you can see in this photo, the person all the way in the back were actually, yes, there are two, there, yeah, I'm going to show another example of this one, but the person furthest in the back is blurred out, and that's because I'm shooting at f5. And here's another example where, again, it's a big group, everyone's clear, I'm shooting at f5, but the people at the back are unclear. They're kind of getting blurred up because of that aperture setting at f5. So in situations like that, that's where I bump it up to 5.6. Again, I'm at that distance of 2 to 3 feet away. I may be on the same plane as them, or I may be elevated, maybe stepped on the platform or whatsoever, but I'm at 2 to 3 feet. And here at f5.6, now I can get a clearer picture of everybody if it's a big group. So take a look at this photo here, and you'll see at f5.6, everyone is clear. Everyone, even the people at the back, they're very clear. So by bumping the f-stop from 5 to 5.6, I was able to make all my subjects clear. No one's getting blurred up. And just to reiterate the f5.6, or show you another example, here's another example. Everyone's clear. It's a big group, yet I focus on the center. Everyone is clear. It doesn't matter if they are further away from the camera or to the left or to the right. Everyone's clear. So those are the three aperture settings I really focus on, f4, f5, f5.6. And again, this is based on 2 to 3 feet from my subjects. F4, I normally shoot if I'm shooting like pairs, even full body or just waist, and makes sure they're clear, and the background is slightly blurred. F5 is for bigger groups at 2 to 3 feet. People who are normally on the same distance from the camera, like they form a line. Okay, so two to three people are on my right, 2 to 3 people on my left, that would be fine. But if I'm shooting big groups where there are people behind me, and so some people are further away from the camera than others, I'll bump it up, the f-stop, to f5.6.